Welcome to the second video in the series, Living with Rheumatoid Arthritis, RA. Let's take a deeper look into the treatment options for patients with RA. The degree of severity is a huge factor that plays into treatment options, and aggressive doses are needed as the severity of the disease progresses. Most patients are initially prescribed drugs that provide short-term relief such as painkillers, including acetaminophen, which have a few side effects. From here, most patients turn to non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medications, NSAIDs, including ibuprofen and celecoxib. These medications are able to provide greater pain relief, but again, do not alleviate symptoms of inflammation in the joints. In addition, these treatments may have severe side effects, especially related to the digestive system. While these are rare, these can include stomach ulcers, kidney, and liver damage. When the disease is moderately severe, patients turn to glucocorticoids as a treatment option. Steroids block immune function, and the medications are able to help in slowing down or even cease the progression of joint damage. Unfortunately, these medications have some severe side effects similar to those of NSAIDs. Therefore, it is recommended that patients only take medications like prednisone when they are experiencing flare-ups. As symptoms increase in severity, more long-term solutions of the condition are sought out. The first options are biological response modifiers, which target the part of the immune system that leads to inflammation and joint damage. They are also able to slow down the progression of RA with little side effects. However, the long-term effects are still unknown. To end off, we have disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs, DMARDs, which have the greatest positive effect with regards to preventative measures for joint damage. Medications such as methotrexate can interrupt the immune function that promotes inflammation. Although this allows for the patients to have reduced symptoms, it concurrently weakens immune system response, resulting in possible infection. In most cases, it is recommended that patients take other medications in combination with DMARDs. For example, most recently, a study by Peter and colleagues in 2017 looked at the consumption of biological response modifiers in combination with DMARDs. They had two groups, one taking methotrexate and infliximab, a biological response modifier, and the other taking methotrexate and a placebo. They concluded that individuals who took the combination of both medicines showed less evidence of joint damage than those that took methotrexate alone. Overall, we find that there are many treatment options for patients with RA, and treatment is unique to the patient's symptoms. We advise patients with RA to ask their doctor about what options work best for them. To learn more about living with RA and lifestyle changes, check out our third video in the series, Living with Rheumatoid Arthritis. Thank you for watching.